In this AUTOSOL training session, I'll be walking you through the initial startup and setup of ACM. For this demonstration, I'll be using a computer with a Windows 7 operating system. Before installing ACM on your machine, please read through the ACM System Planning and Requirements document. You must have .NET Framework 3.5 and 4.0 installed. You will also need SQL Server 2008 or newer. ACM is able to run with full functionality using the free, express version of SQL Server unless you need SQL replication or mirroring for full redundancy. In that case, you'll need to purchase SQL Enterprise. Once you have installed SQL Server, you're ready to install ACM. It's recommended that you run the install as administrator if you're running Windows 7 or newer. To do this, right-click the installer and select Run as Administrator. You will need to accept the license terms and confirm the location to install ACM, but you should be able to run through the installer options quite quickly. By default, your ACM files will all be stored in C drive under Program Files x86 in the AUTOSOL folder. The next step is to either create a new ACM configuration database or connect ACM to an existing database if one has already been created. To do this, you'll have to open up the ACM monitor, which can be found under Start, All Programs, AUTOSOL Communication Manager, ACM Monitor. When open, go to the Database tab and select Manage Database. The first required field is Server Name, which is the name of your SQL Server instance and can usually be found as your server name when logging into SQL Server Management Studio. You also need your database name, which can be custom if you're creating a new database, or the name of your existing database you want to connect to. Next, you need to select the correct SQL Native client for your machine. You will notice that it tells you beside the selection which one to select for your version of SQL Server. And finally, you need to select the appropriate authentication required for ACM to connect to your SQL Server. Please note that ACM requires sysadmin privileges within SQL Server for either Windows or database authentication. If you're connecting to an existing database, you can test the connection. If you need to create or update one, press the Create, Update, Database button. This will open up a wizard. The wizard allows you to create a new database if you don't have one, update an existing database to include all the tables and procedures required for the installed version of ACM, or you can have the wizard create tables and procedures in an existing database if you already have a database created for ACM to use. With this, there's also an option to drop existing tables first if you're reusing an old database and do not need what was previously in there. The next step in creating the new database is to select the SQL Server database options. When selected, each of the options, simple, bulk logged, and full, have a description in the text box below, telling you how that recovery model works. Here you can also select to delete old history in SQL Server. This can be changed after in the ACM configuration in the $ server properties. Select Next, and the last screen will have a description containing how the database will be created. Once you've reviewed the description, select Finish, and the database and tables will be created. Once completed, go to the Status tab and select ASI Data from the list of services and select the Start Services button. If ASI Data starts, you have successfully connected ACM to your SQL Server database and you may now open up the ACM configuration and connect to the server. If you were unable to start ASI Data, there is a good chance that you don't have the right permissions in SQL Server for the user setup on the Database tab. As mentioned previously, you may need to go into SQL Server Management Studio and make sure that your named user or NT authority has sysadmin rights, and if you are using database authentication, that your SQL Server has mixed mode enabled, which allows the use of both Windows and database authentication. If you're using the built-in reporting functionality in ACM, you'll also need to set up the Reports tab of the ACM monitor. This needs to be configured to connect your configuration database just as was done on the Database tab. We do, however, suggest creating a different user within SQL Server for the reporting functionality with read-only access to SQL Server. This is because you can create custom reports, and the reports are a query of the database. Read-only access would prevent changes to the database through the reporting. Once you have input all the database information, select Test Connection and save. For further information on the ACM monitor, please see the ACM monitor training video. Once ASI data is running, open up the ACM configuration and connect to the server. For this example, ACM and SQL Server are installed locally, so we are using localhost. Once connected, you are now ready to begin adding objects into your configuration. You may also want to configure the properties of the $ server object in the configuration tree before getting started. Thank you for watching this AUTOSOL training session. If you have any questions, please go to our website, www.autosoln.com, and click on the support link for all support options.